Hello, I'm Bonnie Urbay. Welcome to TTC Extra. Dr. Jill Biden will be on the cover of Vogue magazine after her predecessor, Melania Trump, was snubbed. In 2018, the former First Lady was secretly recorded venting her frustration, saying, "I don't give an expletive about Vogue and any magazine." Other First Ladies have graced the cover before, such as Laura and Barbara Bush, Hillary Clinton, and Michelle Obama. Donna Edwards, there were two white women, white first ladies on the cover of Vogue within a few months, each of them, and Michelle Obama three times during her 8 years in the White House. They've not yet put up Melania. Is this discrimination of some sort?
You know, Vogue can put who they want on the cover, and I think that their covers actually reflect the mood of the country. And I looked at the picture of Jill Biden, and she is just, her personality just shines in there. So I think it was, you know, I think it was a good decision by them. And, you know, if Melania were an indicator, a cultural indicator, she might have been on the cover as well.
Tiana, do you think it has anything to do with the fact that Melania Trump posed in pornographic pictures several times before, way before she was First Lady?
Okay, I just need to push back real second. I don't think the most elitist, classist magazine of the country, ran by a woman single-handedly responsible for reviving the American fur industry, reflects the mood of the country. But no, come on. They put Stormy Daniels in Vogue, an actual porn star. And quite frankly, if we had an honest conversation in the media, we would acknowledge that Melania Trump, an Eastern European immigrant who at the time was probably undocumented, only did those sort of pictorials because we have a modeling industry that obviously exploits women and specifically immigrant women. No, it had nothing to do about, you know, the pearl clutching of Anna Wintour and all of her other billionaire friends who posed naked for a living.
Tiana, you said she was undocumented. Never undocumented.
Yeah.
She came in legally. So how could she have been undocumented? Where does that come from?
Donald Trump lies, news at 11. I'm saying if you look at the history of her immigration papers, she was probably undocumented. And like a lot of undocumented young women fleeing communism, she was exploited by a sexist fashion industry. For that, I have sympathy. She shouldn't have lied about it, but whatever. That is a very common phenomenon.
Plenty of models who don't really make it and certainly don't make it to the cover of Vogue or any important magazine who don't resort to pornography to make a living.
Okay, I think we should also specify, you know, doing a nude pictorial is not the same thing as doing actual hardcore pornography. I don't think either are things I would necessarily want my daughter to do.
If you saw the pictures, it was close.
I've seen the photos, and quite frankly, I'm not interested in the business of slut shaming. Is it something I would want to do? No. Is it something that I would, again, want my own kids to do? No.
It's not slut shaming to talk about the fact that a First Lady of the United States who was covered up by the Republican Party, posed in pornographic pictures. If Democrats had brought a woman into the White House as First Lady, Republicans would never have shut up about that.
Yes, and that would have been bad and hypocritical, and I would have called them out for slut shaming too. Look, I mean, like, look back to the Katie Hill conversation. There was the very relevant question of, was she abusing power because she was, you know, intimate with a staffer? There was another issue of, why were those photos being disseminated? That was revenge porn and that was slut shaming. The question should always just been, was she abusing a staffer? Those are completely separate issues. With regards to Anna Wintour's choice, she had no problem having Melania Trump on the cover in her wedding dress when Trump was still spreading lies about the Central Park Five and still, you know, engaging in some light 9/11 trutherism. It was just when Donald Trump became a political force, his opinions didn't really change, he just became more of a political force, that then Melania became persona non grata. It's politics, that's fine. It's not my magazine, it's Anna Wintour's decision, but let's just not pretend that Condé Nast and Vogue are some sort of woke bastion of morality.
Okay. Patrice, your thoughts?
So I want to bring the conversation back to the role that this cover is supposed to play, which is to display the woman who holds, I guess, the seat next to the person in highest office in our country, someone who young women should be able to look up to. I don't think there's anything wrong in looking up to someone who's come to this country as an immigrant, who's built a career, who's worked in the very career that magazine represents, and who is sitting as the First Lady of the United States, someone who speaks multiple languages and learned to speak English fluently as well. And to speak to Donna's point about the mood of the country, she was the First Lady when the half of the country elected her husband to be president. So that speaks to, so I think it was obviously a missed opportunity and shameless, and the naked bias is there. But beyond that, I think it goes to the point that, yeah, there are a lot of people in this country who look to magazines like Vogue and say, not interested, because you're never going to represent who I am. You're never even going to represent all women and applaud their accomplishments, regardless of their political leanings or their philosophical association. You know, and it's sad, but it's common to Republicans and conservatives, and particularly women who are in the Trump orbit.
Laura, your thoughts, please.
So I think one of the things that's very interesting about this is an understanding of Vogue's readership. Vogue does, on their cover, quite frequently put celebrities. We've seen Beyonce, we've seen Lady Gaga, we've seen Renee Zellweger. We see a lot of celebrities. Celebrities and Hollywood are kind of part of a more liberal cast. And it is true that the Vogue readership is much more urban, does tend to be more liberal in who's reading the magazine. I think it's also important, though, to understand that when Melania was on the cover, she was on the cover in her wedding dress that she wore with Donald Trump. And in that moment, she was representative much more of the lifestyles of the rich and famous, which again aligned more with liberal elites than, in fact, the political conservative movement, which she became a part of as a result of Donald Trump's presidential run. So I think it's just important to realize that this is a magazine that is highlighting the people who they see as role models, who they believe their readership will also view that way.
So you're saying essentially that by putting two Democratic first ladies, they're going to sell more magazines. If they put a Republican first lady on the cover, they're going to lose a lot of readers that month.
That's right. I mean, that this is as much a business decision as it is a sort of cultural or political statement.
All right. Interesting point. That's it for this edition of TTC Extra. Please join us next week.